Right, and joining, thank you, Andrew. Joining us now from Washington is political analyst Dr. Hussain to give us his view on the latest developments in Lebanon. Thank you very much, Dr. Hussain, for joining us. And sir, parliamentary talks will take place in Lebanon on Monday to try and pick a new prime minister. What is your expectation, sir?
Well, it's anybody's guess. I think as it stands, the alliance that's led by Hezbollah has better chances at obtaining the majority and forming the coming government. Now, the problem is this majority that's being led by Hezbollah now, less than a year ago, was in the minority. At the time, this minority dictated the formation of a national unity government. The problem is, the Hezbollah-led alliance, if they get to name a prime minister to their liking this time, they will not give the other groups the chance to form a national unity government.
Right. Sir, Lebanese leader Samir Gaga called for caretaker Prime Minister Saad al-Hariri to be reappointed as government. Is that possible at this stage?
Well, I think there's a margin of a plus or minus two members of parliament who will decide who will get to be named as the prime minister of the new cabinet. Mm-hmm. And the race is between the incumbent prime minister, Saad Hariri, and former prime minister, Omar Karami. Well, it's the fortunes of both men are changing all the time. And I think Mr. Jaja mentioned that there has been pressures on Lebanese lawmakers from the majority that supports Saad Hariri to shift places and support Omar Karami. So I think it's anybody's call at this point in time.
Right. Sir, do you see any foreign interference in Lebanon's internal affairs at the moment? And if so, where is it coming from? And what do you expect from the international community, Lebanon's neighbors in specific, to help in the political deadlock?
Well, I think so far at the political level, the international community has done a good job. The international community has supported justice, whether by word or by deed or through finance. Many countries have contributed to the work of this international community. But I am afraid that at this point in time, what counts in Lebanon is the balance of power. I'm afraid this balance is